Praise the Lord, everybody. We are back again. We are here, and we are ready to give God the praise that He alone deserves. Today, I want to welcome you to our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp. We are now in our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp. I've been away for just a couple of days, but you have been here. And because you've been here, we have had that opportunity and that privilege to talk to God, to be a part of this worshipful experience. Even though I wasn't here, many were still online and had the opportunity to share. And so this very morning, we want to thank you for being a part of this worshipful experience, knowing that God is able to do all things. I also recognize that Vivia has been on and really has been working the room, and so I want to thank her for being a part of this experience. Right now, I just want us to bow our heads right where we are and just ask God's presence. And as we believe that God is going to do something special for us today, we know that that this experience here is not an easy one, going through fasting and going through prayer, but we believe and know that God will do for us what we cannot do for ourselves. So right now, we ask for the Holy Spirit to be with us as we pray, and we look to Him who's the author and finisher of our faith. Let's pray together. So, Father, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life and strength and this opportunity of prayer and praise. And so this morning, as we enter into our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp, we look to you who can help us in all things. So bless us this very morning, we ask, in Jesus' name, amen. And so this morning, we want to welcome you again to our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp. Wake up and stretch your spiritual muscles and know that God is ever present with us. I want to share a beautiful song with you, a beautiful song by Smokey Norful. And this song is just so beautiful for us as we wake up and we begin to marinate this morning in His Word and in His Spirit.
So good to make it this far, and I didn't think I could take it so long. There were days I wanted to quit, and I said, surely this is it, but I held on. And I've watched as so-called friends turn and walked away, and it hurt so much I didn't have words to say. But even when my day turns to night and nothing seems just right, Lord, I thank you for my life, for my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen, and all the moments I know, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you for my life. And I've watched you take my family from there to here. And when times were a little rough, God, I know you were near. Thank you, Jesus. And the moments I thought I'd fail, I was reminded of your nails. So I held on. And if I never live to see another day, there's nothing I would change or take away. I've had so many ups that they far outweigh my downs. Lord, I thank you for my life, for my life. Lord, I thank you for everything. Oh, and for the moment, God, I know you kept me. Yeah, Lord, I just thank you for my life. I realize some didn't make it. I could have been one of the ones who lost my way. And there were times, Lord, I know I almost went crazy. Oh, but I'm still here, oh, with my life. So, for my life, Lord, I thank you for every victory in you I've seen. Hey, and for the moments that I know you kept me. Yes, Lord, it was you who kept me. So I thank you. Thank you, Jesus, for my life. It may not be all that I'd hoped for, and every dream has not yet been realized. But to see your face one day, God, I know it's all gonna be worth it. Yeah, yeah, Lord. So I thank you for, thank you for every mountain, every valley, God, everything that you brought me through. Thank you for, I know it was you, God. I just wanna take the time to say thank you, Jesus, for my life. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for my life.
Thank you, Jesus, for my life. Wow, that's what we want to say this morning. Thank you for my life. God has done so much for us. And this morning, we chose to wake up and be a part of this worship experience because we believe that mornings are better when you talk to God first. God has a message for us this morning. That message simply is, good morning, this is God, and I'll be handling all of your problems today, and I will not need your help, just your trust. So relax and enjoy the day. And so this morning, we really want you to know that so many people have been calling, so many people who have been online, emailing, on text to say that they have been following the 31-day fast, these times of refreshing. And in during this 31 days, we also know that it can get a little tough along the way. But God wants us to hold on to his unchanging hand, hold on to him, because there's much that he wants to do in our lives. This very morning, we are in our ninth day. And in our ninth day, there's many of us who have said they're not eating meat, they're not eating sweets, they're praying each and every day on separate times of the day. And we want you to know that God will reward you. He will reward you. And he'll reward you in an outward way. And in this, I just want to share with you that in this ninth day, we are praying for spirit-filled youth. That's what we're praying for, spirit-filled youth. Yesterday, we had the opportunity in day 8 to pray for spirit-filled singles. And so we want to just go into this word very quickly, just very quickly, and in such a way where God will marinate these words in our hearts for the whole day. We'll be thinking this through for the whole day. And so even though we'll be praying for our youth, we're also want to pray for ourselves in the meantime. In light of this, I just want to just bow our heads right where we are, and let's look to God in prayer. So Father, we come before you thanking you for all that you've done. We thank you for life, and we thank you for strength. We thank you for all that you've done. Right now, Lord, as we go into this word, we're asking you that you will just bless us and strengthen us in Jesus' name. Amen. And so in this word, I want to share with you the scripture. The scripture is Isaiah chapter 59, verse 21. It says, "As for me, this is my covenant with them, said the Lord, my spirit that is upon thee, and my words which I have put in thy mouth shall not depart out of thy mouth, nor out of thy mouth of thy seed, nor out of the mouth of thy seed's seed, said the Lord, from hence and forevermore." Now, when you look at this text is basically telling us that God wants to have a covenant with us. He wants to have a covenant with us that we're no longer, not only be for myself, but also be for my children and my children's children. You see, we're talking about the youth today. And as we're talking about the youth, it's important to know that many times our youth go astray, or maybe sometimes we go astray, not because we're just not listening or not being close to the Lord, but we're not remembering the covenant that God has for with our parents and with our parents' parents. You see, it's so important for us to understand that God wants to keep a covenant with us. And that covenant simply is simply for our generations to keep, so that we would recognize we have a God that still loves and still cares for us. You know, the Bible tells us to that we should train up a child in a way that he should go, that when he or she is old, she would not depart from it. A part of that training is understanding that we have a covenant with God. And that covenant with God is that he will never leave us nor forsake us. And our covenant with him is that we will never walk away from him. You see, this covenant should be taught not only to each other, but be taught to our children. The Bible tells us, "As for me, this is my covenant with them, that my spirit that is upon thee and my words will not depart." That means God is simply saying that I want to give you my spirit. I want to give you my spirit in such a way that I would not take it away from you. Wow, isn't that a beautiful God? The kind of God that says that I want to give you something and not take it away from you. That's one of the reasons why we're praying this very month. We're praying this month, not just for things, but we're praying for the Holy Spirit. And we're praying for the Holy Spirit to fall on us like never before. And God is saying, that's my covenant with you. My covenant is with you that I'm going to give you my spirit. My covenant with you is that I'm going to give you all these things. But then you got to keep your covenant and keep it. Wow. So that means we're talking about obedience. We're talking about obedience, knowing that God wants us to stay in full relationship with him. You know, this very weekend that just passed, I was away at a conference, and at this conference, they talked to us about adoptive ministries. And it's helping us to recognize that God wants us to be a part of his family. He's adopting us because the way that we have acted and the way that we have done, we have left as if we are orphans. And God is saying, no, just because you have fallen away or you have done your own thing, he's saying that I now adopt you back into my family. He gives us his Holy Spirit. He says, I want to be a part of your generation. He says, I want to give you my spirit, and I want you to keep it, the covenant, forever. And that covenant simply says that I'm yours and you're mine. You know, I have a question for you. I want to play this song for you. And then before we play this song for you, I have the question. What has God given you lately, right, that you are excited about and you're grateful about? Excited or grateful about? What has God given you that you are excited about or that you're grateful for? For me, I would say this. As in Isaiah 59, verse 21, as for me, this is my covenant. I'm going to give you my spirit, put my spirit upon thee. If so, I would simply say, Lord, thank you. This is Paul Graham. Thank you for giving me your spirit. I'm going to ask you this question. What do you want to thank God for, or what are you excited for? What is your gratitude for what God has given you lately? Let's listen to the song as we write these down, and as we ask ourselves the question, what did God give to us lately?
Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul, worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. Your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on singing. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul, oh my soul, worship His holy. Worship Your holy name. Bless You, time has come. Still my soul will sing Your praise unending. 10,000 years and then forevermore, forevermore.
10,000 reasons. I have 10,000 reasons to be happy in Jesus. 10,000 reasons because He's done so much for me. Hey, this very morning, I wanted to let you know that God wants to do much for you. But when we look at this, it's not just prayer for the youth. We want to concentrate on the youth, but we also want to pray for each one of you that you will keep the covenant that God has given you and that you will allow His Holy Spirit to fall on you today. And the prayer simply says, Lord, I pray for the rising generation who is to come after us, closing every door we have opened that gives the enemy access to our children. I pray for young men, young women, and children to be protected from the plans of Satan to destroy them. Thank You for mighty, strong angels engaging in battle on their behalf. And now I pray for parents, our churches, our schools, and colleges to be fully aware of our duty to care for our children in the name of Jesus. And in that, we simply say we want to just remember our young people today. Right now, I want you to know that you can send your prayer request to fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. That's fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. We want to share with each one of you the opportunity to pray for each one of you. In this, if you also would like the booklet to go with the fasting and prayer, you can email me at fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. But I want to pray for each one of you right now. In light of this, it is so important that we send our prayer requests so that each individual that's watching this can also pray for you. So right now, I'm going to ask you, if you're in the chat rooms right now, whether you're on Ustream, whether you're on Praise Vision, or PastorPaulGraham.com at Full Circle TV, just simply send your prayer request at this time because we want to pray for you. Knowing this, God still answers prayers. And if you believe God still answers prayers, just send your prayer request We definitely know that God still answers prayers. In this, there's some of the pictures of the day that we have done all last week. I want to share some of them before we pray together. The ones that I definitely like a lot and that you can always go back and share is when life is too hard to stand, then kneel. I love that one. And then Satan tries to limit your praying because he knows your praying would limit him. And then this one that I like a lot from last week is, no matter what you've done, God is not shocked, surprised, or ready to give up on you. And then this one, Debixi says, those who leave everything in God's hand will eventually see God's hands in everything. And I really believe that God is leaving us with something. So I want to share this with you. I'd like to share this one for today, which is for our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp, which simply says, faith tells me that no matter what lies ahead of me, God is already there. Beautiful. Faith tells me that no matter what lies ahead of me, God is already there. We believe and know that God is an amazing God. And let's keep sending our prayer requests at this moment so that we can pray for you. You can send it to fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. That's fcmbootcamp@gmail.com. And as we look at some of these texts that are coming in, individuals are thanking God for determination, thanking him for forgiveness, thanking him for second chances, thanking him for hope, and others are thanking him just for being the God who hears. And so in this, send your prayer request so we can pray for you. In this, we want to let you know that those who are fasting and praying, don't be faint and weary. Fasting breaks the chains. So in these 31 days of prayer, pray for one another. And today we pray for our youth. Remember our text for today. It says, as for me, this is my covenant with them, saith the Lord. My spirit that is upon thee, and my words which I have put in thy mouth, shall not depart out of thy mouth, nor out of the mouth of thy seed, nor out of the mouth of thy seed's seed, saith the Lord, from henceforth and forever. Wow, the generations, a covenant through our generations, a covenant through the Holy Spirit. And God has given that to us. Let's pray together as we look to God, who's the author and finisher of our faith. Father, again, we come before you thanking you for this day, thanking you for this ninth day of Bible Boot Camp that we have reached. We are here now simply saying to you that we trust you in our lives, we love you in our lives, and we put you first this very morning. We recognize, Lord, that we come to you today first. We come to you knowing that you can help us in all things, you can walk with us in all things, and you can help us in our daily walk this morning. And so this morning, we come to understand that you want to give us your Holy Spirit. You want us to keep a covenant with you. And we're simply saying that as we pray for our youth this morning, as we pray for our children this morning, those who are in colleges, those who are in our churches, those who are in our neighborhood, we ask you to wrap them with your Holy Spirit. Today, Lord, I come before you, ask you to forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness today. Help us to be the Christians that we ought to be. And in this prayer, we recite together, Lord, I pray for the rising generation who is to come after us. Close every door we have opened that gives the enemy access to our children. And I pray for young men, young women, and children to be protected from the plans of Satan to destroy them. Thank you for your mighty, strong angels engaging in battle on their behalf. Lord, right now we want to pause to pray for the parents, that our parents will be all that they need to be. Give them a double portion of your Holy Spirit, that they will stand strong. We ask you to be with our churches, that they will be those safe havens for our young people. We pray for our schools even now, Lord, that they will be that the leaders will help to make the leaders, and be with our children who are in the colleges today, that they would not just learn of you, but they will be like you. We ask you, Lord, to help us to be fully aware that you are on the job and on the case. Bless us, I ask, and strengthen us. And in light of this, Lord, we ask for all those who have left prayer requests in the chat rooms, Lord, praying for children, praying for jobs, praying for schooling, praying for their education, praying for a double portion of your Holy Spirit, thanking you, Lord, for forgiveness. There are others thanking you for helping them as they endeavor on their projects and in their purpose in life. We ask you, Lord, that you will hover over them. And as you have kept your covenant and given us the Spirit, we keep our covenant in obedience. In Jesus' name, amen. And so today I want to thank you for joining us in our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp. Hey, we know right now that we must have faith. And as we must have faith, we know that faith tells me that no matter what lies ahead of me, God is already there. No matter what lies ahead of you, God is already there. I want to thank you for joining us on our ninth day of Bible Boot Camp. I am so excited about what God is going to do for us in the next coming days. Tell your friends about this, but more. I pray that you hold. I pray that you be the Christians that God wants you to be today. So let's walk in His Spirit. Let's be in His Spirit. And let's keep the covenant that He's given us. 31 days of prayer. Let's keep moving forward. Let's keep walking with Him. Be blessed.